Hello, this is Mr. Stansberry. I'm going to take you through the notes on parallel lines and angle relationships. At the end of this, you should be able to say, I can make conjectures about angles formed by two parallel lines and a transversal, and I can prove theorems about these angles. Okay, so let's take a look at some important information first here. So first thing, we've got parallel lines. These are two coplanar lines that never intersect. So these two lines are on the same flat plane here, and they are never going to intersect. Okay, they'll never run into each other. So the symbol for parallel lines are going to be these two long vertical lines here right next to each other. That is the symbol for parallel lines. Okay, next with that, we have a transversal. Okay, a transversal is a line that intersects two or more coplanar lines at different points. Okay, so this here is a transversal. It doesn't have to cut through two parallel lines, but since we already had the parallel lines here, and that's going to help us with the rest of the stuff we're doing, we're going to have this transversal here cutting through these two parallel lines. All right, so with that, we have corresponding angles. Now these are angles that are in the same position on two different intersections. So we've got an intersection here and an intersection there. So if you'll notice, the 1 and the 5 are both in the top left, 2 and 6 are in the top right, 3 and 7 are in the bottom right, 8 and 4 are both in the bottom left, and these, with the 1, 5, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 8, those are all corresponding angles. And hopefully, if we're going to look at this stuff later, but I figure let's talk about it now, is that these corresponding angles here, if these lines are parallel, these corresponding angles are going to be congruent. Okay, so these corresponding angles end up being congruent to each other. Okay, now with that, let's move on to same side interior angles. So these are angles that are in between the two lines, these two parallel lines in this case, cut by the transversal, and are on the same side of the transversal. So 4 and 5 are same side interior angles, and 3 and 6 are same side interior angles. These are also referred to as consecutive interior angles. Okay, so then hopefully we can look at these two and say, wait a minute, let's see, that's an acute angle, this is an obtuse angle. These here are going to end up, when you add them together, they're going to equal 180 degrees. So these are going to be supplementary angles. Okay. Next we have alternate interior angles. So these are angles that are in between the two lines cut by the transversal and on opposite sides of the transversal. So 4 and 6 are alternate interior angles, 3 and 5 are alternate interior angles. And again, if these happen to be parallel, all these things in the blue here are only if these two lines are parallel. You can hopefully take a look at those and notice that these angles are going to also be congruent. Okay. All right. Next, we have alternate exterior angles. So these are angles that are outside the two lines cut by the transversal and on opposite sides of the transversal. So 1 and 7 are alternate exterior, 2 and 8 are alternate exterior. And if you look at those, as long as these two lines are parallel, those are going to be congruent. And again, all of these are only if these are only if these are parallel lines. Okay. All right. Okay. We're going to take a look at another. We're going to kind of put some of that stuff to use here. But before we do that, let's take a little comedy clip break here.
Whenever there's a best of seven series, because then I get to hear my favorite sports reporter question: would you consider this a must-win game? You know, they always feel like they have to say yes. Yeah, we want to win it. It's very important, you know. Got our uniforms on anyway. Might as well try. But it's not always the right answer, man. It's a math question. I wish I would answer that question honestly. It's a best of seven. You're down one game to nothing. Would you consider this a must-win game? No. No, we can lose tonight. We can lose tomorrow night, too. We don't want to, but that wasn't your question. You asked if it was a must-win game, and if you'd ever taken a rudimentary math class, you'd already know the magic number's three. When you're down three, then you must win them or you're out.
All right. Anyway, here we go. Example here. From the diagram, name and write down what you know about the... and then they give us the corresponding angles, same side interior angles, alternate interior angles, and alternate exterior angles. So here's our picture here. And we know that line one is parallel to line two. So that's important. Without knowing that those are parallel, there's some stuff that we do not officially know. So first off, corresponding angles. So the four pairs of corresponding angles, top left. So we've got angle one and angle five. We've got angle 2 and angle 6. All right, we got angle 7 and angle 3. Or let's go angle 3 and angle 7. Angle 3 and angle 7. And then we also have angle 4 and angle 8. Angle 8. And then what do we know about those corresponding angles? We know from what we were talking about before that those angles, since these lines are parallel, they are all congruent angles. Okay, so the two pairs of same side interior angles, same side interior. Interior means between the two lines, and the same side is on the same side. So that would be angle 2 and angle 5. That's these two. And then angle 3. Angle 3 and angle 8. And we know that those two, like the 2 and the 5 and the 3 and 8 and the 8, have to be supplementary angles. Supplementary angles. So they equal, add those two things up and they should equal 180 degrees, right? The alternate interior angles, those are on alternating sides of the transversal. So this is, we could call this T for transversal. So alternate and both on the inside. So 2 and 8, 5 and 3. So angle 2 and 8. And then angle 5 and 3. And we know that these two are congruent, as well as 5 and 3. Those are also congruent. So these angles are congruent since these lines are parallel. And then the two pairs of alternate exterior angles. So opposite sides of the transversal. And then on the exterior instead of the interior. So like say 1 and 7 would be alternate exterior. Angle 1 and angle 7. And then so would 4 and 6, because they are on opposite sides of the transversal, alternate, and then they're on the exterior, they're on the outside of those two lines. Okay, so angle 4 and angle 6, and we know that these two sets of angles also are congruent to each other. So congruent meaning that 4 and 6 are congruent, 1 and 7 are congruent. Same with these up here. 3 and 7 are congruent, 4 and 8 are congruent, 5 and 3 are congruent. Okay. All right. One last thing to look at here. We're actually going to take a look at number 6. It says write the corresponding angles postulate in if-then form. So the corresponding angles postulate says when parallel lines are cut by a transversal, the corresponding angles will always have the same measure. Okay. So if we want to turn that into if-then form, we probably want to say something to the nature of if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, then the corresponding angles are congruent. Okay? Okay, so there that is written down. And then the 6B says, do we have to prove this postulate before we can use it as a reason in a proof? Explain. No, we don't, because if you'll remember, postulates are just accepted as true without having to prove them. Okay? All right, so that's all there is for this parallel lines and angle relationships set of notes. If you have any further questions, please feel free to ask in class. Thanks.